Hi and welcome to this tutorial. In this tutorial, we're going to see how we can use the Jimdo logo designer. So if you want to create a logo and you want to create it for free, you can use the Jimdo logo maker to create a logo. And we're going to see how to do that in this video. So what is Jimdo? Jimdo is a website builder and an online store builder for beginners. If you're someone without any coding skills, you don't know how to design a website, you don't know how to work with HTML, CSS, JavaScript, PHP, Python, all these programming languages that people use to build websites, or you don't even know how to use WordPress, then Jimdo is a perfect platform for you because it's quite easy to use. To create a logo, the first thing that you need to do is go ahead and create your account, because if you don't create your account, you won't be able to import your logo, you won't be able to save the logo so that maybe you can use it in future. Just come here. I'm already logged in, but let's go to a domain where I'm not logged in. You can find the link in the description. I will add the link in the description. The first thing you need to do is create an account. So if you want to create an account, just click there on login. And then scroll down a bit, and then you'll see sign up, and you can sign up. You can sign up with any of these platforms, okay? If you want to sign up with your email, just click there. Enter your email address, user password. You can disable that. And then create account. Create your account. Without your account, you won't save your logo. Let's come back to the dashboard. So here on the dashboard, you can create a website and you can create a logo. If you already have an account and you're not on this page, what you can do is, on this side, just click there and click on my websites or my logos, and that's going to bring you here. So I'm going to click on logos and I will click on new logo. So first, you will be asked various questions. What's your business name? Let's say my business is called Web Guy. I will continue. And then what's your business about? So you can search here. Let's say I'm in graphic design. I'll just click there, graphic design, but you can search there and it will bring different options. Okay, that's the first draft. So it will just give you options of what to expect, how you can use it and so on. So if that's good enough for you, then well and good. You can choose that and use that. But maybe you want a different icon. Maybe you want a different icon. So you can choose another icon from here, multiple icons from here. Let's just search if there's anything related to web. Web should be something like that. Let's say that's the logo that I want to use. And I can change the layout. So you can use, this is the layout that is currently being used. I can use that, or I can use that. I definitely prefer this one. So out here as well, you can also prefer this one, that or that. So let me just choose this one. You can also choose any of this. Okay. If you don't want to add the icons, you can choose any of this. Look at all this. Just choose something here and build from there. You can even choose that here under layout. There are lots and lots of options. So look at all these options. There are multiple options there that you can choose from, countable options that you can choose from for the layout. So the layout is how your design will be. And then the font, you can change the font. Perhaps you like that font. You like this one. You can choose one of these fonts and use that font. That seems okay. And then colors, let's see what options we have for colors. Now here for colors, maybe you want a custom color. Maybe you want your logo to have red and that. So maybe you want these inner elements to be, let's say you want them to be red. Do I have color picker? Let me pick this color. And I will come here under custom. And the color for that, I want to use the one I've copied. Paste, done. Oh, no, not that. Which color did they copy? Let me just use that. Done. And then this side, maybe it can be red, and it can be red and something that's close to black. Done. That's a very weird logo combination. Okay. I say that's done, and then this side we can use something that is reddish. Now you can see my logo is not that pretty because of the colors I've chosen, but maybe let me remove the outer layer. I can come here and choose a different layout. Okay, so you can see based on the colors I've chosen, everything has been put with those colors. So I can therefore change my logo to be something that will match those different colors that I've chosen. Perhaps I want to use that. Yeah, that seems much simpler. Or even that, but let's use this. So it depends on you. What do you want to use? If you want to use a different layout, go ahead and use that. You can even use that. Let me choose that. So let's say that's the logo that you want to go with. You can also change the business name. So if you messed up in the business name, you can edit the business name there. So once you're done editing the logo, you can just click there to download for free. And I'm already registered. So I'm just going to click on download for free. So make sure you're already logged in. So no, I don't want to see the website. Let me just close that. And if you come here under logos, you'll see your logo. Then you can download your logo. They're trying to get me to design a website. If you don't have a website, you can see what options they have there. And I can download my logo. So once you import your logos in here, once you extract your logos, once you download them and extract the logos, you can have a look at the logos. There we go. Right, so you can see you even have icons that you can use. In this video, you've seen how you can create a logo using the Jimdo free logo maker. If you want to create a logo, just go to Jimdo. The link is in the description, and then you can create your logo as I've shown you in this video. Use all the options to create your logo. You can customize your logo based on the different options that I've shown you in this video. So that's it for this video. And if you want to create a website, go ahead and see the website options that you have as well. I will see you in another video next time.